Welcome, beautiful people. Welcome to yet another video. I hope you guys are feeling great. I am feeling great and I'm glad to be back with another video. Of course, you know, it's summer period and I have to be giving you transfer news. I'll be giving you some Chelsea news. I'll be giving you some updates for the Euro 2020s and hopefully you enjoy this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up, share it to the family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the post notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a video, and let's get right into it. So for the Chelsea news, guys, I have to tell you, as I told you in my previous video, the Premier League table had been refreshed. So what does this mean? The fixtures were right around the corner and they are out. So we know who we'll be going against for the season. Heading towards the season, we'll know which teams we'll be going against. And guys, I have to say, this was a very interesting fixture. So for the starting week in the season, we will be going against Crystal Palace, then we'll be going against Arsenal, and then we'll be going against Liverpool. So guys, I know as Chelsea we have had a reputation in the past when it comes to playing against the top teams. We always end up having great results, and we always show up, and we're just great towards the game. And when it comes to the teams that are mostly in the bottom 10, we struggle, we have a tough time. But hopefully this season will be different. We have a new coach. He extended his contract, as I said in my previous video. We are looking to sign some great players. We have been linked with the likes of Erling Haaland, the likes of Hakimi. And guys, hopefully this will be a great season for us. I will be on the lookout for when the game starts, and I hope this will be a great season overall. So that's it for the fixtures and for some of the Chelsea news. Then let's get right into the transfer news. As I said, I will be giving you some transfer news, and it's really hot here, but so is my news. I am coming in hot with my news, and these are the transfer news. So a little update with Hakimi. Inter Milan mentioned that Hakimi will be going for 80 million euros, and Chelsea have made a counter offer of 60 million euros plus Marcus Alonso. And PSG is still linked with Hakimi. They're having a pole position and are moving ahead with talks with Hakimi. So guys, it's a back and forth between PSG and Chelsea. The seesaw is, you know, PSG up and then Chelsea, you know, up and down. I think you get the point. And this is really interesting to see. So I will be giving my opinion about it. We are offering 60 million plus Marcus Alonso. In my opinion, I feel like this is a great offer. I mean, Marcus Alonso is a great player. He has had some great time on the pitch. We have seen some of his assists, some of his play time on the pitch has been really great. And I feel like Marcus Alonso plus the 60 million is a great offer for Hakimi. And PSG are offering 65 million with no player. So I feel like we have an advantage over PSG, and I feel like Inter Milan should go for the offer from us, from Chelsea, and they should just sign. They should take the deal. I mean, Marcus Alonso, he was part of the team that won the 2021 Champions of Europe. So that should count, guys. What do you think about this deal? And how do you think the talks will go on as we move ahead? So that's it for the Hakimi news. Then guys, it's a sad news for Fikai. It's not really that sad. It's kind of sad, but again, it's an advantage in terms of Fikayo. Fikayo Tomori is said to complete his contract. He will be signing his new contract with AC Milan, and it's safe to say he's happy there. They will be extending his contract up to 2026, guys. Wow, that should say something about the player. I mean, the clause will be 28.5 million euros. So guys, I feel like it's okay. Yeah, Fikayo Tomori looks really happy. He looks really content with the team. I feel like if he would come back to the Chelsea, you know, so many players are in Chelsea, and even the signings that we're making, is this really necessary? But we do need a solid striker, and we need to make, you know, a few adjustments here and there. But it's okay. I feel like we are okay with Fikayo leaving. He was not for the English squad, for the English starting squad for the Euros. So guys, it's safe to say he's happy there, and I wish him all the best. I really hope he enjoys his time there. 2026 is a long time from now, so all the best to Fikayo, and I really wish him nothing but luck if luck works in football. Then on to some major news, guys. N'Golo Kanté. Oh, guys, you know how everyone feels about Kanté. Although he is so humble that he even says that, oh, guys, it's not such a big deal. I'm just a normal man. It's just, I feel like N'Golo Kanté does not have a lot of media presence, hence why people don't get to make him a villain in any story. But he's actually a very nice player. The way he played for France yesterday night, well, I'll be getting onto that a little bit later. But Chelsea are looking to extend his contract, and they're currently going on with talks with N'Golo Kanté. And guys, this is great news. N'Golo Kanté as a midfielder is a classic player. If he's currently playing for the Euros, and if his team France is able to win for the Euros 2020, guys, he is on his way to winning a Ballon d'Or. What do you guys think? I mean, he has won a Champions League, he has won the World Cup, he has won FA Cup, guys. N'Golo Kanté, I think it's safe to say he deserves it, and in my opinion, this extension of the contract is just, it's just well timed. He deserves it. He's a phenomenal player. When he's on the pitch, he's always covering ground all over the pitch. His interceptions are incredible. So this is just great for Kanté. We just need to sign Kanté for as long as possible. Of course, I feel like he's at the peak of his career, and the fact that he's playing for Chelsea is a plus for us. So I hope that his contract extension goes through, and we get to see N'Golo Kanté in action for more years to come. Then guys, finally, for my last news, I have to mention this. Harry Kane is still in talks with Chelsea, and Chelsea are still working their way around on how to make a deal with the player. Of course, Harry Kane is from Tottenham, and he has been found in the past to make comments in the lines of, I need to win a trophy, I am at the peak of my career, I need to be doing something great with my career at the moment. He's one of the highest goal scorers in the Premier League currently, and guys, if in my honest opinion we are to go for Harry Kane and we're able to sign him, I feel like it's better than even signing Erling Haaland. Unpopular opinion, I might get it, and you guys might come for me in the comment section, and I'm ready for the bantering. Hear me out, yeah? Erling Haaland is in the Bundesliga currently, and Harry Kane is an experienced Premier League player, and he scores greatly, he has great goals. He even assisted us get into the top four for the Champions League for this season when they won against Leicester previously for the previous season. So, guys, it's okay, he's more experienced in my opinion. He's more experienced in terms of the Premier League. We don't need another season where we'll have the likes of Timo Werner. You know, I'm not comparing Timo to Erling, well, kind of, but Timo came to the Premier League and he was scoring, but he was always offside. We don't need another transition for a whole season in order to be able to get another season so that we are able to be getting goals. We need goals. So if we were to sign Harry Kane in place of Erling Haaland, I am all for it, guys. Comment down below on how you feel about that, but that is how I feel. Harry Kane, a more experienced player for the Premier League. If we sign him, we are more likely to get more goals. We are more likely to, you know, possibly even win the Premier League season 2021-2022. Comment down below on how you feel about that. The only limiting factor I have to mention, though, is the fact that Harry Kane is a bit on the older side. Erling Haaland is still in his early 20s. Erling Haaland is still in his early 20s. So he has a long way to go. That is the only limiting factor in terms of Harry Kane in comparison to Haaland. But other than that, we should sign Kane, right? We should just, if he comes busting out of the door, we should be like, hey, how much do you want? We should sign him ASAP. So guys, other than that, that will be the transfer news for today. Tell me your opinions on who do you think we should sign. How do you think we as Chelsea are moving on with talks with the players? And tell me how you feel about the transfer news today. Then for my updates for the Euro 2020s, guys, this is an interesting one. So as I mentioned previously, I will be giving my updates for the Euro 2020s in terms of the players from Chelsea on who played against who. And let's get right into it. So first of all, we'll be having Germany versus France. Of course, we had N'Golo Kante participating. He was the only person from Chelsea in France who participated. And from Germany, we had, of course, Rudiger and Kai Havertz. Guys, I was more lenient for France. I was leaning towards supporting France only because of Kante. Who does not like Kante, guys? So I was rooting for France in this one. And I was hoping they win. And they won. Although it was an own goal, they won with a 1-0 win against Germany. So Kai Havertz and Rudiger had taken L in that one. But it's okay. It's okay. We still won. Yeah, we still win when our brothers win, I think. Timo Werner too came in as a substitution. I think I have to mention that. And it's safe to say that players in the Euro 2020 from Chelsea are making an impact. They're doing great. Of course, Kante was all over the pitch. Kante, the exemplary player, works extremely hard. And you can see the outcomes in the pitch. He does not take anything to heart. He's just a disciplined player. So kudos to France for winning. Although it was an own goal, kudos to France for winning that. Then I have to mention this, guys. I am in the vicinity of Turkey, if I may mention that. And Turkey, I have to say, were making noise for the Euros. Guys, it was all over. Oh, we are participating in the Euro 2020s. We're going to win all the games, most of the games. But guys, it has just been a bad start. A terrible start for the Turks. And it's not going their way, guys. Okay. Let's just say I am not for them, yeah? No harm intended. I just choose whoever I want to support. And, well, they have making a lot of noise. And they have been losing. So, they were bantered last time. And this time against Wales. Wales gave them a 2-0 win. And let's just say that the noise has gone down a little bit. The volume has gone down. They need to pull their socks. Turkish, Turks. You need to pull your socks. You can do better. You can do better. And I wish you all the best. And hopefully you guys can pull up your socks. Well, I had thought that I should just mention that as an update. Finally, we have Italy versus Switzerland. Italy, we had, of course, Jorginho representing Chelsea and Emerson. Although Emerson was just in the substitution list and was not able to perform, was not able to go on the pitch. Jorginho was exceptional yesterday. I have to give it to him. Italy won with a 3-0 win against Switzerland. So that was a great win for Jorginho and Italy overall. So that will be it for my Euros roundup, weekly roundup. I really hope you enjoyed it. And what other news? Do you want to hear from me during this summer period? Of course, it's hot. We are free. As I said, I'm done with school now, so I have a lot of time. I have a lot of free time. So I'll be waiting for your suggestions on what you would like, what content would you like to see. I was thinking of doing my 2021-2022 prediction for the Premier League season on how I think it will end. Although I think it's a very interesting and heavy job, I will be willing to take on the task. If you guys are interested, tell me whether you're interested down below, and I will definitely do the video for you guys. Other than that, that will be it for my video. Please follow me on my social media handles. Thank you so much for the love you guys showed me in my previous video. Keep on sharing the video, and I really appreciate it. Thank you. Please don't forget to like the video if you've reached this far and enjoyed the content. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the post notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a video. Yes. Share the video, by the way. Share it. Yeah? Yeah? Okay, cool. And I will be seeing you in my next video. Bye. Tell me what you like. Fresh boy got the spice, yeah. Hello, kid.